this tremolo is the key. See, what? Here's what you need to do. You have to ask yourself, what is your top speed? It's almost like if you're in the NFL, they want you to run the 40-yard dash to see how fast you are.
Right.
Pretty simple. A metronome will help you get timing, but if you're playing skills going dun 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 dun, that's not making you faster. And if you can play a rhythm to a drum machine, that's what you need. You don't need tick tock tick tock. You know, and I'm making a joke about it, but metronomes are very useful. Don't get me wrong, for BPM. But it's not going to do what you need it to do. A good drum software, go online, just get some loops to like play with inspiration. You know, that's the idea, to be inspired, not to. So, but here's what you need to do. You need to increase your picking speed. And the way to do that is just tremolo one note. Can I have that chord again?
I don't need to be.
You do the stage thing too, wrapping it around. I do that myself. But see what he needs to do is speed up. You need to get it fast like that. And hard and aggressive. See, right now you're about. But see, that's your. It's not super fast, but you're capable of it. You're young. You know, plug it in. Don't wrap it around the thing. But but just try it. And then the Speed Kills DVD will show you a lot of exercise, but do it on higher. Do it higher. Oh, that's that. Is that Pulp Fiction?
Yeah. It was a good song to practice.
Well, that's right. It's a tremolo.
Yeah, and that's what I was thinking.
Yeah,
that's
try it. Let's hear it. It's not. Try it faster. Try holding one note and just go. Faster. What if this beautiful woman said, if you could play really fast, I'm going to date you?
That's about the fast max speed I've got
right
now.
Try it again. See, it's getting faster. You've got to find a way to speed that up. That's your PPS. And see, once you figure that one out, because everybody's capable of it. It's not like it's some, you know, the lost secret. Yeah. The secret that hasn't been found yet. It's what this is really just finding your way to play correct. Now, see, I have a strange picking style because I'm lefty. And I was real little when I was a kid. And so I actually held my guitar like this. But what I do is the same thing a lot of other great guitar players do. We limit the range of motion right here. When you play slow, you nuance it like that. But when you play medium speed or fast, whether you're Brad Paisley or Al Di Meola or John McLaughlin or Joe Bonamassa that plays like this, or you're John Petrucci or Yngwie or myself or countless other guitar players that play like this, we only have one thing in common, and it's what we do here. This is actually kind of meaningless, really, because there's players that I can name that do this and don't do and play like this that are equally as good. So there's two basic techniques. You either put your finger down some way or you don't. And see, but the idea is they all find this PPS. They get it going fast. And then they use that as their basic style. But if you work on that, I guarantee you for 10, 15 minutes a day, a few days, maybe a week, you'll find a way to start getting much faster. I think just no one's ever told you about it.
Yeah, maybe.
You know, but I know how to, and the Speed Kills program is going to give you exercises to practice to play fast.
Yeah, that's killer. I saw some of your videos online, but
You're getting, this is like the Shred Bible. It's me when I was real young going, I'm going to give you the keys to the Lamborghini. You know, it's that one. And you get the original DVD, but because it was done in VHS. But it's based on classical piano technique. I have a degree in music. Doesn't make me smarter or better, but I studied music. And so I took piano. I asked, how did Bach do this? How did Beethoven learn how to play fast? Somebody taught him. They all had teachers. And you can go back in history and find piano books. And they all had, I kept watching this and said, well, what's going on here? Dun, 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun. It's called the Hanad book. Short exercises. played repetition over and over and over. This isn't about shred guitar. It's not about rock guitar, country guitar, jazz. It's just about technique, just to be better you. You know, that's all I taught was not saying, I'm not going to be political, but I don't, it's not like watching Fox News or MSNBC. I don't care which side on guitar. I like all the techniques. I have no bias of techniques because one, if you want to play a riff and you don't have the technique, you can't play it. But if you do, it's like my analogy is, you know, more weapons in the arsenal. You know what I mean? So that's really the way I look at it. And because the techniques are for you to use, not for me to tell you what to do. But the Speak Hills program has all these short exercises that are designed for one thing, to bring your technique up and to make you a better, faster guitarist. And it works. It works great. Do you guys have any questions? Yeah.
I have a problem with my pinky.
Your what?
It's my pinky.
Okay. Can I have that? Yeah. That's great.
Hammer-ons and pull-offs.
Yeah. Can you plug that in?
I'm sloppy and I end up cramping up.
Yeah. Let's Yeah. If I'm climbing the walls, this is a lot of sugar.
So.
That's actually pretty good.
But I can do it shortly, but it's like I don't have enough control.
What about using your third and fourth finger?
For this?
No, like 4-3-1.
Okay, I have more power with these, but my pinky, I can't do it for as long as I need to for a song.
Is there a riff that you need to play? Is it kind of like an AC/DC type riff?
It's the lead out of a Blacktop Mojo song.
Which one?
It's Pyromaniac.
Oh, okay.
But like I said, it starts out up here. Then.
Yeah, I'm tuned down a half step. Okay, here's what I do when I warm up. Could I have that cable, please? Yeah, I like to give kind of an unforgiving sound when I'm doing this because it shows it's easier to find out, you know what I mean? Versus if it's a super easy tone to play. When I warm up, I do really simple exercises. You know, one of the things I always say, like I've never been hurt playing, and it's the truth. And I mean, you know, I'm older now, you know, I play all the time. Get no sleep, but here's what I do. You have to strengthen your fourth finger. You know, you're talking. I mean, what you're playing sounds fast enough to me. You know, like when I was doing the sound check, I don't know if you guys watched it, I was doing like these Zach Wild. Really fast. And so what I did was when I practice, I practice the same thing over and over. If you're having problems with your fourth finger, mm-hmm. you got to exercise it. And the way I do it is real simple. There's a lot of exercises out nowadays that are hybrids of the simple stuff. My thinking on guitar is to start in the foundation. Because see, a lot of younger players, my metaphors, they know the roof. But then all of a sudden when there comes a time in their playing, they don't have this foundation, and then they hurt themselves or they can't do something. See, where I would rather start from the ground up than the top down. Now, what I did was this. There are really simple exercises to do to strengthen your fourth finger. And I'll tell you what I do. I do this every day of my life when I practice. I start off 1-2, 1-3, 1-4, and I just literally play slow. One of the things that I've said over and over, and I learned this from classical piano, it worked for Bach, it worked for Beethoven, it worked for Schoenberg, it worked for Chopin, you know, and so Rachmaninoff. And so I think it works for us, you know, but to play fast, you have to learn how to play slow. See, you have really good technique. I mean, your technique's really good using your fourth finger. So it's not like you have a problem. It's just that, it's like, it's just,
strength in it.
Yeah, you just gotta work it. You know, it's kind of like, you know, I'm on 10 pounds and I wanna go to 15. So I go to 10 to 12 to 15, you know, with weights. But here's what I do. I keep a good finger hand positioning because, see, this is really key. Music is not sports, but there's one thing that I learned a long time ago, like music is a life lesson, you know, just, and you can, I learned something, and this is how I'm going to answer your question. I learned about adjusting my game as I've gotten older from, believe it or not, that guy Phil Jackson, who used to coach the Chicago Bulls. And I'm going to tell you why. He wrote a book that I read. He won as a player. Then he went to Canada. He won as a championship as a coach. Goes to the Bulls. He wins 6 championships. Goes to the Lakers and he wins 5. He won in every single thing, the big game. And here's what he said to Michael Jordan. It was a great saying. And here's how I'm going to apply it to you and everyone else and to me. He said, when Jordan won 6 championships, he went into baseball and wasn't very good. Then he goes back into basketball and he won championships again. And here's what Phil Jackson said to him, and this applies to us. He said, now, music is not like sports. Music, you're using big muscle groups. We are like this. You know what I mean? We're like, ah. And so he said, Michael Jordan, he looked and he said, at 28 or whenever Jordan came back, he said, you are not the player you were at 21. He said, you're not this guy, that Air Jordan guy. You can't do that. You're 28. You know, sports, that's a lifetime. He said, you have to adjust your game. And so what did Jordan do? Instead of flying to the hoop like he did when he was younger, he developed a fadeaway shot where he would go and he'd back up and he was deadly. And so, and the moral of this is like what we're doing. If you need to strengthen this, and this is like what I was saying with you about the hand, you've gotta be careful that when you practice these exercises, that you do it right. Because if you do it right, your learning curve's like this. If you do it wrong, you plateau out. And then you go, shit, I can't, you know, I'm no faster. Yeah. So this is the world according to Mikey. Now here's what I do. All you need is some practice. You've got the technique, it's already there. You know what I mean? I mean, you don't need it. Yeah. I mean, I just add alternate picking to it to make it sound faster, but it's really not much faster than you're doing. It might sound like it because I'm picking it, you know? But like if I go, that's not that fast. It's just fast when I pick it, you know, because that's what gives it that machine gun sound. But here's what I do. First, I watch my technique. I try to keep my arm, you know, think about, watch your hand and think about if it was at your side. Does it look like this? Does it look like this? Or does it look kind of like that? So you want to make it natural. Start in fingers 1 and 2. In yours, I'm going to just jump to the chase. 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4. So here's 1, 4. All the way up to the 12th fret. I do this every day of my life. I start in fingers 1 and 2. And back. Now, look at my other fingers. See, they're not all over the place. See, they're really close. See, this is what you want to do. If you practice slow and smart, you get so much better faster. Okay, and you don't hurt yourself. When I learned classical piano, playing scales slow blew my mind. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti. Do, re, mi. So you have to go, and it's like to play it slow really burned it in your brain. You are really close to being super fast like that. And so here's what I was saying. What's that?
Yeah, they like maybe.
Okay, but it's true. You know, like you're not playing like, you know, like that. It's control. But when you have control like that, then what's the difference between somebody who can do it and can't? Just isolating it, you know, and that's what, you know, I see this stuff right away because I worked on it myself. And I've taught a lot of famous guitar players. I'm teaching one now, I can't say who it is, but he can fill 15,000 seat venues and he plays hit songs all night. But his technique too, you know, he's touring and he's a little worried because, you know, he's been in, you know, 15 years into it, and all of a sudden, you know, the hand starts to feel a little bit, and I'm adjusting his playing too. And so anyway, when you play this, it's fingers 1 and 2, from the first to the 12th fret without stopping. And you play it slow. And watch what your other fingers, so it's fingers 1 and 2, then 3, 1 and 3. All the way up to the 12th fret. And alternate pick it. Then here's where you come in, 1 and 4. And just, now see, here's the trick. You don't want to do this. Just like that. Now then it gets harder. 2 and 3. All the way up to the 12th. Then 2 and 4. Starting here, but I'll start here. So again, you're working your fourth finger. Now look at my other fingers. The technique is right there. Then the hardest one, 3 and 4.
When
I was teaching the really famous guitarist, his first two fingers playing this were like this. You know, here he can play all these hit songs, but he can't do this. And I said, you have to force your fingers. This is the force on your fingers. See, look at where my fingers are. And I'm gonna tear it up tonight. Because, see, I can control those fingers. But when you do this and you play it slow, all of a sudden, this starts to get better. And then what I end with is this. I just do 4 fingers. But I play it slow. Every note. And see, I'm not going like when you play guitar, you want to pretend there's an imaginary line that's perpendicular to the body. And because every human hand wants to move towards the headstock. That's just the way our fingers work. We never move out like that. They go this way. So the goal is to not have it move past this imaginary line. The line is here. So if your finger's here and you're doing an exercise, you don't want to move it past there. So when you're doing this, and you watch your other fingers, and again, this DVD that I'm giving you, Speed Kills, there's a downloadable version, but I mean, a lot of people do downloads now, but that's from the company. They gave us these DVDs. I mean, I still have a DVD player, but it's the original one, but it's got all these exercises in it. But really, you're really close. And I'm not gonna say that. I mean, I'm here to help. I'm not here to like say, everything, it's wonderful. I know you can do it. You know, I'm not some kind of yoga teacher or something. You know, okay, class. You know, so this is really trying to help. But you're fine. Your technique's really good. You know, so I hope that helps. But you just gotta work it. I mean, think about it as going to the gym. And if you just isolate exercises slow, just something as simple as, even when you were doing that, do it slow, about 10 minutes.